We're here outside of the world famous Milestone Club in Charlotte, North Carolina, with Torch Runner from Greensboro. You guys played a hell of a set tonight. Tell us about how the experience is different playing in Charlotte and as compared to Greensboro.
I don't know. It's definitely, even though we're not that far from Greensboro, it's definitely a whole different crowd. I feel like, I feel like people have more fun in Charlotte. Greensboro's kind of old and jaded, I feel like.
I just heard about legitimate business shutting down. Could you tell me a little bit about that?
Basically, the fire marshal asked us to change a lot of things that we can't afford. It's just not in our price range, and we just rent the building right now, and it doesn't make any sense for us to spend that kind of money on a place that we don't own.
Yeah, they gave us a capacity that was really, really low. But you know, I feel like that happens to all DIY spaces eventually. We're really lucky that we were able to be a part of legitimate business for two plus years, you know. And it was definitely a great thing, and all the bands that played there and everything. It was awesome while it lasted.
What was your favorite show at legitimate business?
I like the idea.
For me, it was... Okay, I got three. We got to play with my favorite band, Legit Biz, Strike Anywhere, and it was right when we got home from tour, so that was really special to me. But then two different shows, my favorite bands that I got to see play Legit Biz were Tombs and Clinging to the Trees of the Forest Fire.
For me, it was Magrudergrind and Cough.
Yeah, that show was great too.
Yeah, that was a really great show. tell us about any like new stuff you guys have coming out.
It's in the set plans, but
we're working on it.
Yeah, we've been trying to we got home from our tour right before the beginning of summer, and we've been trying to kind of take it easy since then and write a lot, and hopefully have a new record before we do another big tour. So I guess that's kind of our short tour. We're just trying to have a new record.
This will be our first record as a three-piece as well. So it's been a little...
How was the transition from being a four-piece to a three-piece for you guys?
Easy.
Really?
Yeah.
I mean, I was just asking because I know how hard it is to play and sing at the same time, because I've tried to do it before, and I have absolutely no timing to do that, so...
Well, I used to only sing and not play anything.
Yeah.
And I guess it got to the point that I knew the songs so well, it was just a matter of knowing where to put my fingers. And I played bass in almost every band I played in before Torch Runner. So once I learned the bass lines for our songs, it kind of just, and did it a whole lot, it kind of became easier. And I don't really have a problem with it anymore. It was definitely something that I had to get used to.
So, out of all the cities you guys have played in, what would be your top five?
Top five.
Cities.
Like Oakland? Rock Hill first.
Rock Hill, Oakland, Rock Hill, South Carolina, Oakland, California, Asheville, North Carolina.
Yeah.
Nashville, Tennessee, and Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania, with an honorable mention of Portland and Seattle.
Yeah.
Nice. Well, thank you guys for talking to me.
Yeah, of course.
we're here with Magrudergrind from D.C., outside of the world-famous Milestone Club in Charlotte, North Carolina. So, guys, how did you like playing in Charlotte tonight?
It's fucking bloody.
It was awesome.
It's your first time in Charlotte, right?
Yeah, man.
I've never been here before.
Yeah, I don't think any of us have been here. You're been, right?
Actually, I just remembered. I played at Lunchbox Records a while ago.
Yeah, Lunchbox is pretty rad. I saw you guys last time you were, when you guys played in Greensboro at Legit Business.
Oh, yeah.
How would you compare the two cities, Greensboro and Charlotte?
I don't know. We didn't really get to spend too much time in either, so it's kind of hard. But people definitely went off tonight.
It smells like Lysol here, dude. It's different. Can you smell that? I'm like, I'm getting lightheaded right now.
It's all right. They just cleaned up the bar. They're keeping it clean. It's good. Yeah, both shows were awesome. Greensboro has never disappointed, and this is the first time here, and this was awesome.
You guys are on tour right now with Despise You.
We're
on tour. This was after the tour was over.
Yeah, it was like two shows.
Second show
without
three shows on the way back without Despise You.
All right, cool. Tell us about the tour. How was that?
It was pretty fucking amazing, man. Those dudes keep it real as fuck.
Hell yeah.
And shows were phenomenal. We just like got, you know, broke down on like a real level and musical and personal level, so it was cool.
Yeah, there wasn't one bad show on the tour.
No.
Yeah. And they're from LA. They like keep it real chill, so it was like nothing really fazed them.
And everybody in the band is like a different personality, and they're all amazing. They're all awesome people.
So yeah, kind of want to make out.
What was your favorite show on this tour?
Boston was sick.
Gainesville was.
I think Tampa.
Tampa
was sick.
Brooklyn was sick.
Yeah, I mean they're. I don't know,
they're all.
There was no bad show on this tour.
So there's just a whole tour.
This was fucking awesome.
A tour long tie, you'd say.
Yeah. Yeah.
All right.
This was the biggest surprise because I had no expectations for the last three shows, and this fucking brought it.
Yeah, dude, tonight was
when they announced this show, I was so stoked because I was like really bummed out because I wouldn't be able to make it to Raleigh because it's
where do you live?
I live in Lancaster, South Carolina, and it's like,
is that right across the border?
Yeah, basically, it's like an hour from here. And it's like 3 hours from Raleigh, so I definitely wasn't gonna be able to make
this. Your friend puked. Your boy just vomited.
Did he? I thought he was just sniffing.
Oh,
he's
pissed.
No, he took a piss.
No, he's pissing.
He's sniffing it again.
Pardon me.
Is he another race question?
What's he doing? Is he hitching a ride? He's about to ditch you. Oh, no, he's going back.
No, he's still pissing.
Not done.
Yo, bro.
There's
dude, just go over here in the bushes, man.
There's like five better places to go.
Still stepping in his piss.
Look at that shit. Is that not a better place to piss?
Than this?
Than right over here? Oh, man. Sorry, I took over that interview.
You seen that Method Man interview when the dude like grabbed the microphone? He's like, let me tell you something about interviewing, motherfucker. He's like, so I heard you have a problem with so and so, blah blah blah. He's like, motherfucker, give him that shit. He's like, when did I ever say that I got beef with anyone? Dude's like, let's switch the interview. How long you been interviewing for? It's funny.
We don't have beef with anyone who's not dead.
Except that one guy from Boston who played in a band called Hill, man. Yo, why does Nick tape hit me up?
Wait, can we...
Worst
can we put,
interview ever.
Can we put...
This is actually the most entertaining interview I probably ever conducted.
Dude, Nick tape me up right now? 25th birthday.
Oh yeah, he's airsoft paintball arena or whatever.
Such an idiot.
Yeah.
We should interview these people.
They probably have something to say.
Yeah, probably just a little bit more important than we
are. Oh, they're walking across the street.
I think they appreciate you giving them a letter.
Yeah, they do. I yeah. It's cool.
Alright.
I don't need to smoke.
Yeah, you don't.
So are you guys working on putting out anything new?
Eventually. It's a slow thing.
Alright.
Slow process. It'll come out eventually. An LP is the next. Stuff.
Sick. Hell yeah. I remember
Dude, they had a Donald Duck shirt.
That'll sound the same as everything else.
Fuck yeah. Well, dude, that is amazing. Get that in there. Some silly stuff.
Alrighty.
Well, thank you guys for talking to me. It's been fun.
Yeah, thanks for hanging out.
Thank you.